When I first used that term to describe this phenomenon, I thought I was making a metaphor. Later on, I found, no, it's a literal reversal, what I'm talking about. It is a literal reversal. A reversal of what? A reversal of the energy. Totally reversed in a reversal state. Now, the important thing about a reversal is that the person cannot be treated effectively if he has that state. It's just impossible for him to be treated successfully if he suffers from a psychological reversal. So that's the way we always launch our treatments, by testing for the presence of that reversal. And we know it's not there before we begin treating, or else we wouldn't have a chance of helping the person. Because that's a very important point. It's not relevant to just TFT. A lot of people think that, but it isn't. It covers all treatment categories, and the description that fits is that the reversal will not allow any kind of treatment to get past the reversal unless the person is corrected. And that's a very, very important, because, in other words, we'd have all treatment failures if you couldn't fix the reversal. How do you measure reversal? Well, we can measure it with a voltmeter. And we look at the scale. We take the leads from the voltmeter. There's a red and a black lead. And we put them on different parts of the body. I'll make this very brief. And if the reversal is there, it will show up on the voltmeter. It'll show as a, the polarity will show to be negative when there's a problem, when the reversal is present. The voltmeter shows it very clearly, and it's a revolutionary development using the voltmeter in that way, because that's one way where everybody can actually see the reversal, because it's on the scale of the voltmeter. They can see it, so that's an enormously helpful educational tool, very, very helpful. The nine gamut, which consists of different aspects of the treatment, with the eyes closed, open, down left, down right, whirling in a circle the other way, that's part of the nine gamut. And those are very good and very effective treatments. And when I say good, I mean effective. They're effective. And I understand some therapists are putting the nine gamut aside, which is a terrible mistake. They won't have very effective treatments when they do that. The nine gamut, first of all, in the first stage of diagnosis, it's saying, hey, I need some help here. I can't make this without some help. That's the patient's subconscious talking. And so all of those treatments are indicated by diagnosis. This needs to be fixed. And fortunately, with diagnosis, we know how to tell when it's fixed and when it isn't fixed. It seems like such an obvious question that it's hard to treat it at face value, but we can tell what treatments are needed. And like, some clients will come and they'll need every treatment we could ever think of. And they get better as we fix those different problems. How do I know the treatment for collarbone breathing? Because when we put the diagnostic aspect of this on review, it shows a need for it. Well, I identified the culprit that way because it was, in fact, an energy toxin. And what do I mean by that? I mean a toxin that's affecting the system of energy that we are addressing and trying to make corrections to so that the person will be free of his troubles. And that's how it works out, really. A very high success rate, especially when we identify the role of toxins in the recurrence of a problem. It's what we call an energy toxin because the system that is injured and blocked from operating is the healing system. It can't work with that reversal in there. And so we call it an energy toxin, and we know how to correct those energy toxins so that their effect is minimalized or eradicated. We have a test, a muscle test, where we say, let's say that we don't know what it is that's causing this recurrence of a problem. The treatment went very fine, but then later that day, when the patient lit up a cigarette, all of his problems came back. And so that was a clue that the cigarette is an energy toxin affecting the energy system.